a little bit.
Ernesto Williams is a realist.
All right, come on up, bro.
As the owner of this 24-hour barbershop in Buckhead, he knows hard work pays off.
I kind of like the challenge of things.
But he's not too sure about luck. In fact, he's never played the lottery.
I guess it's just I've never been excited about it.
I think it's a fluke, kind of like, you know.
And at first, he told us $290 million might be too much money.
A lot of money. It changes your friends, your attitudes, everything. Everybody changes when you get money. You get kind of bored.
And then you come out your mouth and say you'll be bored.
Customer Curvis Glover couldn't disagree more.
I pretty much play when it get high because it seems like it's about that time for it to be. Somebody to make the money off of it.
And after talking with us, Ernesto started having second thoughts. He slipped next door and surprised us with this.
This is my first ever. First one. So it's got to be good luck. First day of January.
How you like that?
At least this once, he'll take a chance and keep working hard. Jennifer Leslie, 11 Live News.
Every hood got their own hustlers. But this is the hustler's anthem. Hustle hard.
Try to make me some money.
Nice.
Yeah.
What do you love
today? I don't know, man. Maybe another 20 more days.
No, no, no.
Yes, sir. You got 20 more days to deal with us.
No.
Yep.
Don't tell me like that.
I ain't with it. I get free coffee.
No.
Kidron say free.
No.
Yes.
No.
Yes, he did. Okay, I'll bring back later.
Come on, man.
Nah, I don't have no money, man. Hey, I'll be back later.
I'm the biggest boss that you see thus far. I'm the biggest boss that you see. I thought you were Big Nesto.
No, this is Big Nesto. Well, the Big Nesto is God of Stairs. I'm the second Nesto. This is number three, and this is number two. Oh, yeah, this is for the haters.
He just said he see a lot of people with barbershops, but he ain't not seen a 24-hour barbershop before that's run so successful by a black man. That's what he told me.
Well, I mean, you know, sometimes you gotta, first of all, you gotta believe in God, and believe in God, and continue to believe in yourself. It ain't nobody gonna believe in you but yourself and God. Believe that. I just thought, I took a lot of thought, a lot of time, when I was locked up, thinking about, you know, you and your sister and brother. I had a lot of time to myself. You know, I didn't sit around, sit on the bunk, play cards, look at TV, like a lot of clowns do. Don't have a plan or a vision. They just sit up there and play games with their life. Like, I got started playing with my life. I understand it's all my future, so I had to start playing before I got out. So I pulled everything together. So everything on paper, every day, every night. Got out, saw some things work.
Did anybody help you when you started?
No, you know how it goes. Just sit on the bunk, tell them lies, talking about what they gonna do. Tell them about $1 million dreams. They got this and got that. And when you get out, you leave you on the bus stop. You know, one dude left me on the bus stop. I always say, Nesto, I got you, man. I got you when you get out. Got out, called him. Called him about 3-4 times. Had me sitting out there for 4 hours on the bus stop. That's why I called the bus stop. Sell him, you know, penitentiary game.
Where your first spot was at?
Started out there this morning. Stayed out there, old lady gave me a little chance. Old Debbie. Old Debbie Johnson, that was her name. That was me getting. Had a little game by herself, but I appreciate it because she gave me a little game.
Hi there. Hi there.
It's dope the shop is 24 hours, brother. What's the longest shift you think you ever pulled straight? Like without phone, like, no shower, like straight grind.
Probably the longest shift. Probably be a month straight. No showers, no sleep, a little bit of food, straight grind, nothing but haircuts all day, all night.
Now, you ever had a barber that left your spot and got their own spot? Yeah, I had one. Mr. James Kynes. Yeah. Yeah, he opened a nice barbershop. Actually, he opened up two. And he learned a mistake from the first one. And the first mistake that he made, can't believe in dreams. The dreams that other people say. And he paid a valuable lesson for that. One thing I do respect him for is, he came back and said, hey Nesto, let's do this thing again, man. I need to start all over again. I respect that man for that. Now you got another barbershop. bigger and better. So sometimes you got to lose the game. And a lot of folks don't understand that rule of thumb of the game. You have to sacrifice
and bow down and recognize and understand that that it's always not a loss. And sometimes we as black men, we think that we let our ego get in the way. And our ego get in the way, it destroys every time. And he didn't let his ego get in the way. That's why I said respect. I'm proud of him, very proud of him.
Actually, I met Ernesto and I met each other spiritually before we even basically met each other physically. You know, one Sunday, he visited a church that I was attending. And at the time, I was working with a business management firm. I was the director of their sports division. And I just always think like, okay, I have to elevate myself. I have to elevate my game, what I need to do. So initially, I was thinking, you know, upgrade my car. I need a new car. And I was a Beamer person. I always liked Beamers. I always wanted one. And so when he pulled up, we actually parked right in front of each other at this church that I was attending. I was a member and he was visiting. And when I saw the car that he was in, I was like, wow, I like that car. He had some real nice sporty rims on the car. And it was very clean, but it was corporate. And it kind of fit what I felt like would have been my mode. And, I heard God say, turn in that shop. And I was like, God, you need to find something for me to do. Because I ain't trying to stand no feet all day, trying to be in a barbershop all day. And I heard him again say, turn that barbershop right there. And so in the middle of the road, I basically got over, I busted a U-turn and turned in, and I went and spoke with Ernesto about an opportunity to come and cut hair.
One dude said, remember that guy in front of opening up over there on Roswell? And he come beating on the door. Ernesto, I know you in now. He saw my car out there backed up. I know you in now.
What kind of car was it?
Yeah, one of them old SLs. Run. You know how they do when they get a little caught.
What you had?
I had a cell. But I had something to let everybody know I wasn't playing no game. My car is a trophy. My car is not a luxury thing to sit around and play with women with. That would a guy get the game twisted with. That's a luxury. A luxury as a trophy that you work on.
It's a product of Ernesto Cuts. The real deal. This is that trophy I was telling y'all about. Butler tie. Ooh, this thing is hard. Butler tie. Ernesto Cuts is going into the new. It's going to the new barbershop. Yeah,
that's fine. But anyway, that's what gave me an idea. Like, that's what I know you're in now. See y'all in here. I'm sleeping on the floor. This is my shop. You're gonna make money, because I believe in it. You have no investors, because all the investors are scared. Because investors don't believe in you like that. You gotta believe in yourself. That's the only way you're gonna make.
How long has Fat been up?
Well, we've currently been there 7 years. Time to retire over there. Time to go to the next level.
Which is the 18-wheeler mobile ball shop.
Take this mold to the next level so I can go ahead on the NASCAR. I want Ernesto Cuts to take it to the next level. I need to get on up in there with the big boys. For real.
What's the business?
NASCAR. That's the big boys. NASCAR. Ain't nothing bigger than that. I mean, they're bigger than in NFL. Them boys getting it. I just want to see, can I do it? That's all. I mean, if I ain't ever one day, I'm good. I just want to make sure I made it. You know what I'm saying? Because it came with a thought. Came with a thought.
I send my shouts out to it. 25 Barbershop does a great job. If you notice, you can look amongst all of the walls, which he has three great big walls. Great pictures of great guys and ladies that have been through the 25 Barbershop. ATL stand up, we put it down all day, 24 hours, 365, all year long, baby.
I just happened to be riding along the street one day and seen this on the main strip, Peachtree. This is the ATL, baby, where everything happened. If it's happening, it's happening on Peachtree.
So with that being said,
Have you ever been inside? I know you got the mobiles and the barbershop stuff. You seem trying to do the beauty salon. How is that going to work out for you?
Well, the beauty salon is going to run great because I have a vision in mind to protect the women. See, there's a lot of beauty salons out here not taking the time and thinking about the women that are spending all that money, the weaves, the color. You know what I'm saying? They ain't really taking time to looking at the security. They're not looking at, you know, okay, if this lady's spending $500 for a weave and a half, okay, well, guess what? Take the time out to have somebody cater and walk her to the door, or take the time to have somebody to go pick her up. You know what I'm saying? Take the time and say thank you. They don't even say thank you. They just say, oh, this girl come to get her hair done. You know, I don't feel like messing with her because she ain't such, 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 but she pay her. No, I want a woman to feel like a woman, that she going to get all this stuff done to her for what? For somebody to look at her and give her some attention. And she still ain't getting the proper attention that she needs. You know what I'm saying?
So you feel like your strategy is where they can get the proper attention at?
Most definitely.
Why is that?
Because for one thing, I can't do it all by myself, but I can start with me to be able to understand that our African-American black women that's out here done tucked over, and our black men done laid down. You understand what I'm saying? And it is some good black men out here, you know? But they just ain't getting a chance. The reason they getting a chance because they get beat down so much because of the suckers. The suckers is laying down. You understand what I'm saying? You got women taking these men off the street and fixing them up.
What's the definition of a sucker to you?
I'll fix them up, Negro. You know what a fix them up Negro is?
Nope.
Fix them up Negro run around here on the side of the road trying to figure out where he going with a pan hanging down. No game, but he talking about his gangster.
You said, say that again now.
He walking around in circles. Out there in the middle of the street with his pants down, trying to figure out where he's going, talking about he a man. He'll wolf up to the girl and say, hey, you got to pay some bills over here now, you know. No, I ain't paying no bills there because I ain't got no job, and start making these excuses and make these women feel like, you know, they the fault. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Still standing up. Because the way I growed up, I mean, your uncle, your nephew, or whoever bigger than you, they'll knock you down and make you feel like a man. And you number 10. But now, get on that sound. Oh, you hurting him. Don't hurt my baby. You see what I'm talking about? You can't even chastise. You can't make a man out of no man. Now I tell you what. You hurt my baby. I'm going to call the police on you because you hurt my baby. And as soon as you hit 15, you start pulling that gap guy on you. Then you be like, So that's what I'm saying. Then men my age, they ain't nowhere to be found. And I'm calling them all out. You know why I call them out? That they scared of the young boy. See, I ain't scared of them. They scared of the young boy because the young boy get loud on them. You know what I'm saying? Pop, what you looking at? Pull the gag out. I pull the gag out too. Because I don't go take it to them like that. Talk to them like a man. That's the difference. And that's what these women out here got to understand. To be able to start talking to these men and nurture them. Because that's what the women here for. To nurture a man after he get through hunting. He clowns don't know how to hunt no more. The women are hunting them. So guess what? I feel with my salon, I could say, okay, I can at least have a little chat set. I ain't got to charge to do that. You know what I'm saying? Make a woman think, okay, you know, you're right. You're right, Nesto. Not if a dude go out and get the hustling and he get locked up and she go to the next man because she need her bills paid. That ain't no woman. You understand what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So if a woman believe in you, she gonna believe in you. But it's sad, man. I don't even want to talk. Go ahead on, bro. Let's talk about something about that. They ain't talking about that. What else? What else you want to know?
Well, that you've been in the game for over 10 years, how many shops have you seen that's really getting to it? They're really cutting, not spray painting, not penciling everything in, just really getting to it, other than yours?
I don't want to give him it proud, but I ain't no hater. I ain't no hater. And he might hit on me, but I don't care, but I'm going to
give him a gangster, so I don't really care. But
old good fellas, I'm proud of him because me and him bumped our heads one or two times. But I would take my hats off to Ron because he used his head.
First of all, when I first got out, I seen them old Mexicans out there. I'm out there riding the bus and seeing them Mexicans out there load up out the QT. I say, man, where all these Mexicans come from? You know, when I'm gone, it wasn't no Mexicans in the line like that. When I came back, that's all I seen. I ain't seen no black people standing out there trying to get no work.
Well, yeah, you was gone.
I'm gone in the early part of the 90s. You would love it then. The bitter baby.
Well, yeah, you came back.
Came back in 99. That when everybody talking about the world going in. That's when they talking about the computer from the crash and all that. Yeah, the world ended all right. The world changed. Changed a whole lot when I came back. Seen a lot of nothing going on. But I seen something going on. I seen them Mexicans, seen out that QT. I said to myself, I ain't never letting them Mexican husband. I had no problem with it, but you know, I guess I was like, man, I ain't understand what they had going on. It was coming up. We were falling every day. All we were doing was killing each other. Killing each other's spirit and our dreams.
You still care?
Yeah, I'm gonna have time to time, you know, keep my skills polished up.
Who all that you cut?
What you mean, who all I cut?
If I who all you cut? Like.
I can't believe you asked me that.
I mean, I just want to know. I mean, some people out here faking, saying I cut this person, that person. I mean, I know you ain't no flexor, so I'm asking you.
You know who my favorite person that I cut? Out of all these years that I've been cutting hair.
A little bit for me.
Out of all these years I've been cutting hair. Now, I take that back. It's two people. There's really two people that I really got something from. One, when I was doing my time, I used to cut out them in the baseball field. When all the other barbers wouldn't let me get in the barbershop, so I had to cut out in the baseball field. With a razor and comb, never forget. And his name was Andre Wade. He gave me a chance. He said, man, don't bump me up now. We're going to get the fight out here in the yard out here. Mm-hmm. And that was funny to me, but we did get the fight, though. We did get to fighting at the end of the day, but we've been friends for about 17 years now. And my next person, the favorite person is I've been cutting, is Jasper Williams. That's my favorite client that I learned a lot from. Older gentleman, pastor. Not saying because I cut his hair, just that, you know, he has that wisdom and that knowledge, you know, that I would like to one day pass on to a young man my age. I ain't really young, but I'm all right. But, yeah, I appreciate everybody having cut, because without them, without the people, I can't be nothing. For real, for real.
So just on the side of town that you really, really, if you had to move your spot, that you'll stay in, the area? Or would you pick another area? Be 24-hour wise?
Nah, just on this spot of the work in. Just on this spot of the work in.
Why you feel like just on the spot of the work in?
Well, it's the way the sun set. A lot of people don't understand the way the sun. The way the sun come up, the way the sun set, from the morning to the afternoon to the evening. You can see where the traffic roll. You can see where the angels come in, and you can see when the devils come out. So, I mean, you know, for real, fair, think about it. Most people that live in the suburbs, they go home, go sleep, take care of their kids.
Let me start asking out a question. Enlighten me on some areas. Let me know what you got going on.
Like what?
As in, since the whole time you was gone, what you thought about? But I thought about from way from the early 90s when you said you first left, not the 2000s, the early 90s.
Well, one thing about it is I figured I ain't gonna never let them folk trick me again. And that's what most of they do, they trick all the folks who don't have the education to educate themselves. That's one thing. Second of all, once I realized that I was tricked, I just sit down and say, listen, man, I'm just gonna give it all to God and just ask him to just please help me through everything I was going through while I was gone. The only thing kept me going for the whole time was thinking about you and your sister and brother now. How I'm gonna make y'all proud, how I'm gonna make y'all to be able to understand a legacy that I can help build. We can maintain it together for years like the others do. And I just want to be different, be the best father I can be when I came back out. To be able to educate y'all. That's basically what I was thinking about. That's what kept me going the whole time. No matter what nobody else.
I'm listening.
That's it. I mean, I really kept to myself. I was just really trying to seek knowledge from the older guys, you know, who had life experience waiting for me, who had life sentences that were willing to share the things they would do if they had a chance to do it all over again. And I just took advantage of that. That's all. I just humbled myself. I didn't want to. I was foolish, just like every other young guy was foolish. But I guess God just put his hands on me. To understand life. And like I said, I really thank God for what he has done for me.
It ain't about all the material things, the money, the women. It ain't really all about our life. What it's about is how you can save somebody's life without making mistakes you done made. So that's why I be cutting up and I see you be doing this stuff. Being mean or I'm hating on you, as you say. No. I just seen,
when you're gone, when you're away from your family and your holidays go past and you see all this stuff on TV, you start like, man, I wish I could be with my family so I could be doing this and that. We don't take advantage of all that stuff when we're out. We're free. So by me taking advantage of thinking about what I could be doing positive in my life to stay out here with y'all, that just motivated me. You're priceless. You can't find you every day.
I'm priceless
all day long.
Being a 24-hour barbershop, I don't sleep in here weeks at a time. Not just, oh, I'm up. Yeah, I take a nap, you know. I ain't never fell asleep in between the cuts. So 24 hours meaning, you know, really get 24-hour money, not sleeping on this money. You understand? Understand me? You know, my daddy being a person that he is so busy to be his age, it doesn't seem like he's going to be retiring until he's about 80, 90, maybe even 100. But with that being said, yeah, I wouldn't mind taking over, but I can't see myself taking over with the way that he moves. He moves too swift, like.
He's not on time. Well, I really don't mean try to think about retirement, because I'm a busy man. I love to be busy. I like to be active. To me, when you feel that you need to retire, you might as well be dead. Okay, guess what? You're no longer useful in the world. To me, the way I feel, the way I am, be 46. If I can't keep my mind active, my body and soul active, I'm no good to live like at all. You should feel the same way. You can't help nobody. You can't make your mind go real broad out there. You can try to
better yourself even more. Because it's only stuff you live for is really dangerous, for real, for real. I don't care if it's a cracker. You want it. You know what I'm saying?
So what you're saying that you always got to be active, you know what I'm saying, that you build your shop yourself? That's not happy.
Well, I build it myself with my mind first. See, you got to have, you got to sit down with a thought first. If you don't have a thought, that's what I'm saying. If your mind and your body and soul is not moving, you can't think of nothing. That's why I'm always moving. You know, you already about to be saying, that's it, you move too fast. I don't move too fast, you move too slow. You can't keep up.
Trying to walk in his footsteps. I couldn't do that because it's only one Nesto, one Ernesto, and put like that. It's only one person like that, one of a kind. Ain't too many people you're gonna find that can do that. Son, not son, brother, sister, twin, cousin, auntie, uncle, even his daddy. Can't nobody move how he move. But with that being said, I wouldn't mind taking over though. I just wouldn't want nobody to look at it as that. Oh, he's not doing it like Nesto. He's trying to be Nesto because I can't try to be nobody but me.
Memorable experience, I have to say, I don't know if I could pinpoint it down to one, but for the sake of the interview, I was surprised when I seen a lot of different celebrities coming through this spot. I really like that. Well, I mean, you know, I got MVP last week, but I'm not gonna say I'm the best, you know. I put it like this. Ernesto 24-hour cuts, we got a strong five. Any barbershop in the city, y'all wanna set up a nice non-profit game or something, get your five and come see us.
Hey, you know cutting me here? Ain't no cutting me here. You don't want to get cut over here, though?
I can go get myself, though. My stomach doesn't suck.
Yeah, I could.
Why do you need to be cut? My stomach should have been ready right now when I came up.
I just came taking my son to track me.
Track me.
Yeah, no, I'm trying to do it, get everybody cussed because we're going to put a move and all that down.
Don't get stuck, man.
Nah, sure, appreciate you, though.
Hey,
I'm going to
work with it.
Yeah, I need winners on this thing.
Come on, man.
He said he want to do all your promotion.
Yeah? Okay. Who is
that? Chuck Mike. Somebody that got it.
Oh, yeah. Now they want to do promotion. When I was thinking about them, nobody want to think about me. Now they want to work with me. Now.
Everybody wants to be a star. A star. A living star. Living the past life in big dreams. On the cover of a magazine.
The Empire.
Cause everybody wants to be a star. A star. A star.
They take their pictures everywhere.
Grand finale to it. Make sure you have a Bob Shop. Let y'all know when you're playing no games. How you doing, sir? James.
Yeah,
man. Y'all feeling good here? Y'all all right?
Yeah.
Ain't too hot?
Why you getting a little warm?
Okay, but we finna cut it back on.
Let's go. What you trying to do?
Hey, man. Hey. Dude told me you need to hear everything you got to say, bro.
You know, this is my spot. When I'm in ATL, I'm on the old coast. I'm from Boston to Miami. When I'm in ATL, this is where I be at, Chuck. This is my barber, Chuck, ATL. I ain't going nowhere in Atlanta but here. That's right.
Mr. James Kine right here. Get a good look at him. Tell him what you offer.
What are you offering them next? No, we have a men's room lounge and spa on Far Road, Kings, Atlanta. We do everything from head to toe, men's grooming, hand, foot, detailing, massages, facial, image wardrobe consultation, the whole nine. It's a kingdom of grooming is what we call it. This is my brother who I started in the business with, so we kind of do what we support him, what he has going on with his vision of his mobile barbershop is quite extraordinary.
This my playboy friend. This my playboy friend. This my playboy friend right here. Chuck Luck.
Yeah.
Tell me where you at, Chuck.
Since limelight.
I'm Chuck, aka Picasso. Mr. 24 Hour Man. I am the 24 Hour Man in the flesh. And, you know, I'm just here to support my man. You know what I'm saying? This right here is a great thing. You know, we're taking the barber thing to the next level. 24 Hour Empire.
Hey, this is TJ. Tell them where you're from, my main man.
I'm from Alfie, come on.
That's where you at? Yeah. Star
International. Best,
yes, celebrity barber in ATL,
in Okonsha, Kamasana. We're taking the game to the next level. That's how we are right now. That's how we are operating.
Hey, check us out. Tell them where you're from.
I'm from Nigeria. Africa. From the motherland.
Yeah.
Motherland.
Hey,
that's how we do it, man.
Let them know, did you run LA?
I run every goddamn thing.
We got a real, another real sports analyst.
Analyst.
That'd be at. What's happening?
What's happening?
NBA Finals. NFL lockout talk. Baseball season. What's up with Tiger? Is he hurt for real? What's really going on, Tiger? He's having
steroids. One more. Got to bring all the best, all the backup, the best. Ass mark.
Yeah.
What it do? No. Straight from Jersey, Trent, New Jersey, repping it real hard. Down here in the eight. I mean, you can see it. Man has done things that has never been done in the United States. 24-hour barbershop. We got an 18 Wooler. I'm a truck driver myself. This is like my dream vehicle. So for those who don't know, this is a serious piece of equipment right here. Peterbilt, stretched out. We got three stories up in here, four stations. It's crazy, stupid.
You gotta respect the grind. You gotta respect the grind. Cause if you try to be in his lane, there's no use of getting in his lane. He's making it to where there's no competition. If anybody try to run to the same lanes, there's no use. Do some painting or something else. That's just what it gotta take. You know, that's what happened. Like when you dealing with urban markets too. Like everybody want to do the same thing. Everybody want to be barbers. Everybody want to be models. Everybody want to be rappers. Everybody want to do hair and all that. You gotta create the lane to where you in the lane of this untouchable lane. And that's what he did. I respect his hustle to the fullest. And I'm off.
The Bulls ain't exactly been blowing people out of the playoffs. But the Bulls haven't been exactly blowing people out of the playoffs either. I mean, they struggled against the Pacers.
So after I found out there was a building across the street and it was abandoned, I went over there and asked the man, I said, man, give me a chance. If you give me one chance, I'm going to show you what I can do. But that one chance ended up being 7 years.
24 hours, 7 days.
Who slept in the shop with you when you first got it?
My kids. You and your brothers and sisters. Because I had to make y'all understand, ain't nobody gonna give you nothing out here. You gotta get it on your own. Nobody. They talk that good game, but they don't. Once you start believing yourself, then everybody start believing.
You gotta prove yourself.
So we ran the spot while you were gone.
I had a nice lady, her name was Carol. Sweet lady, she was 100% behind me. 100%.
Did she run the way you ran it?
Well, she did her purpose. She did the things she needed to do. She kept the doors open, she listened very well. She did what a woman's supposed to be doing. She's supposed to be able to maintain while a hunter go hunting. Not a woman supposed to out-hunt a man. Anytime you got a woman out-hunt a man, it's a problem. He's not a man.
Yeah. Hey, count that money for me, partner.
Hey, Ross, make sure that nigga got that shit right, you hear me?
Hey, when that motherfucker go ding, that's 150,000. Yeah. That shit should add up to about 5.4. Yeah. I'll be right back, man. I'm finna go get dripped. Yeah. Tell me the gas up the jet.
I stay on my grind, could that come first? If he get out of line, his feelings finna get hurt. All that's on my mind, it get that door. You try me, I'ma take it places you don't wanna go. 50, 60 stacks of moon when I'm in your town. Just don't shake a booty, home run, then it go down. Yeah, that click, clack, move, it'll hit back fast. At attention when you see me, pledge allegiance to the swag. Pledge allegiance to the swag.
Pledge allegiance to the swag.
Pledge allegiance to the swag. Off the motherfucking chain, play the game how it go. I ain't in the game, still I'm a problem on the low.
What
the
thing was all about this, what you believe in, what you think you can do, can't worry about what nobody else talking about. The folks I call them dream killers. I ain't gonna let nobody kill my dream. You see this money maker? This something that people be scared to do. They're scared of gas prices. Worry about what everybody, their friend, girlfriend, boyfriend say. You can't worry about what nobody talking about. You got to fulfill your dream before you get to your destiny. That's why I ain't cut my house 45 inches. That everybody want to be around me, whatever. The ones, the suckers I don't want around me, they'll move on. The winner's going to stay behind. That's all I'm looking for. Attract more winners. Winners bring winners. Losers bring losers, and I'm not a loser. This is what you call a cold gangster truck. Good. Straight from the scratch, ground. Drove all the way from California to Bakersfield, California, with no heat. Searched this thing for 12 weeks. So I got what I needed. You gotta have a personal security guard for this thing. Not when you bought it. Out of control. All these clowns, you need Bentleys, Ferraris. Get a challenge. See, this thing here take gas, insurance, DOT. It take all that to run this big boy. So I had to make a leap for myself.